Abraham Maslow, who you probably already know from this chart, Maslow's hierarchy of needs,
dedicated most of his career to understanding how to unlock human potential. Specifically, he spent a lot of time understanding how people can achieve a sense of self-actualization, which is living in alignment with your highest values, consciously achieving mastery over yourself, and realizing your true potential. Self-actualization was, of course, at the very top of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. But a few years before he died, Maslow started to revise his most famous idea.
He started seeing self-actualization, his own proposed pinnacle of human potential, as incomplete. In his unpublished personal notes revealed after his death in 1970, Maslow expressed concerns over self-actualization being too individualistic. The true pinnacle of human potential was something else. Maslow called it self-transcendence. To understand self-transcendence, we have to understand what Maslow called peak experiences and plateau experiences. Maslow said peak experiences are rare, exciting, oceanic, deeply moving, exhilarating, elevating experiences that generate an advanced form of perceiving reality and are even mystic and magical in their effect upon the experiencer. It is the feeling of great ecstasy and wonder and awe, the loss of placing in time and space, and finally the conviction that something extremely important and valuable had happened, so that the subject is to some extent transformed and strengthened even in his daily life by such experiences. Maslow believed that self-actualized people have peak experiences more often and at higher intensities. Peak experiences became kind of a marker in Maslow's psychology for identifying self-actualized people. Not every peak experience is had by a self-actualized person, but every self-actualized person has peak experiences, and generally lots of them. It's a rapture of vital energy that feels like mystical contact, and Maslow even saw peak experiences and people trying to communicate them, induce them in others, and create values that may bring more people to have peak experiences as the origin story of every religion. But before he died, Maslow wrote about something that he considered to be beyond peak experiences, called plateau experiences. He actually got the term from U.A. Asrani, who was a professor of physics at Banaras Hindu University and a yoga practitioner. Maslow describes plateau experiences as a kind of unitive consciousness, the simultaneous perception of the sacred and the ordinary. There is a paradox because it is miraculous and yet it doesn't produce an autonomic burst. This type of consciousness has certain elements in common with peak experiences like awe, mystery, surprise, and aesthetic shock, but are constant rather than climactic. The words I would use to describe this kind of experience would be a high plateau. And unlike peak experiences, plateau experiences can be turned on and off by the experiencer. And this sense of control is key to understanding self-transcendence. In contrast with a merely self-actualized person who attracts more frequent and intense peak experiences, a self-transcending person is able to ride the lightning of the peak experience so well that it turns into a plateau. You're able to go in and out of the state as you wish. Funnily enough, it's when you transcend the boundaries of your sense of self that you're able to gain the ultimate self-control of being able to access this unitive psychological experience at will. Maslow links transcendence and the plateau experience in the following words. Transcendence can mean to live in the realm of the plateau. After the insight or the great conversion or the great mystic experience or the great illumination, one can calm down. As the novelty disappears and as one gets used to great things, live casually in heaven and be on easy terms with the eternal and infinite. I can then even feel some subjective equivalent of what has been attributed to the gods only, that is omniscience, omnipotence, and ubiquity. Perhaps the best word in order to stress that this is part of human nature, even though at its best, is the word meta-humanness. When you dig into the major religious traditions, you begin to see that they all had terms for the psychological state. In Hinduism, you find sahaja or natural samadhi, in which full spiritual or transcendental consciousness coexists with full outer awareness but free from ego sense. As the writer and academic Arthur Osborne says, the final state is stabilization and is beyond ecstasy, pure universal consciousness flows through a man, uses his faculties, and performs the function which you ascribe to the ego, only much better. You find the same or very similar ideas in Sufism as Baka or Hakikat, the Bodhisattva state in Buddhism, the Vitaraga state in Jainism, and the unitive state in Christianity.